about 80 different countries now, and usually to very strange places, to war zones or drug dealer havens or the hideouts of Marxist guerrillas or just really weird places where you collect odd diseases. But in all of that, I have learned some important things. Travel itself is, I think all of you know, one of the great educations that you can possibly get. You must remember the first time you went to Europe. And the air is different. The buildings are magnificent. And you're just in heaven. It's like being alive in a way that you've never seen before. And we hitchhiked. We went all over the place. I tasted cream, European cream, and European pastries for the first time. And we hitchhiked, as I say, and got picked up by soldiers on their way to Pamplona to run with the bulls, and we wound up running with the bulls for no good reason. We slept under trees. We got thrown out of youth hostels. We got picked up by a lovely Italian, southern Italian couple who were kind of like Romeo and Juliet. They were running away from home so they could be married in Austria. And all of that was magnificent, and one night stood out more than any other. It was in July of 1969, and we were passing through Nice. It was an important time. We wound up at the University of Nice with a crowd bigger than this in a room watching the lunar landing where men walked on the moon for the first time. And this crowd was silent as we saw Neil Armstrong step down, pause on the step, and then put his foot on the moon and said, "That's one small step for a man, one giant leap for mankind." And the place burst into applause. And these are the French. Fantastic. Everybody, everywhere that I met, felt that we were all part of one great family. And that we, not just Buzz Aldrin and Neil Armstrong and NASA, we had accomplished something beyond belief. Man had walked on the moon. This was 1969, you know. Martin Luther King had just been killed the year before, and Bobby Kennedy had been killed the year before. Civil rights was still raging. The Vietnam War hung over everything. All of that was hanging over us, and there were dark days ahead. But for that moment, we all hung together. And I learned that the world was a wonderful place. A magical place, and from then on, I was committed to the idea that what I wanted to do was travel. What I wanted to do was see. And if anything else came of it, that was great. But mostly, I just wanted to wander. And so I have. And it worked out rather well. What I learned was that for all the travels that you make, for all the lessons that you have, those cliches are true. It's really the people that you love that matter. It's really what you care about most in the world that you should hold on to. And however far you travel, and you probably already knew this, but I guess I had to learn it, when you come home and there's somebody waiting for you, there's no greater experience. It might have taken me a long time in my life to realize that as fully as I have, but ladies and gentlemen, that is exactly what I've learned. And God bless you for being in the travel industry, because you teach that lesson to people every day.